매주 FGTV 뉴스입니다. 우리를 위해 십자가를 지신 예수 그리스도의 고난을 묵상하는 고난주간 특별 새벽 기도회가 15일부터 한 주 동안 진행됐습니다. 첫 소식 심지혜 리포터가 전해드립니다.
엿새 동안 마련된 고난주간 특별 새벽 기도회는 십자가상의 7언을 주제로 개최됐습니다. 이는 오전 9시부터 오후 3시까지 6시간 동안 십자가에 달렸던 예수님이 남기신 마지막 말씀을 의미합니다. 첫날과 둘째 날 기도회는 이장균 목사가 그리스도인이 당하는 고난의 의미를 주제로 설교했고, 셋째 날부터 마지막 날까지 극단의 고통 가운데 남기신 예수님의 7가지 말씀이 다뤄졌습니다. 17일 이영훈 목사는 예수님께 받은 용서를 힘입어 이웃을 용서하면서 살자고 당부했습니다.
우리가 우리 죄를 용서해 주옵소서, 그래서 용서받은 것이 아니라 먼저 예수님이 십자가에서 몸부림 피로 돌아가시면서 우리의 모든 죄와 허물을 끌어 안으시고 돌아가신 것입니다. 용서하신 것입니다. 그렇기 때문에 우리는 그 용서에 힘입어서 우리 이웃을 용서하며 살아야 합니다.
성전을 가득 메운 성도들은 예수님 고난의 참 의미와 주님의 유언을 마음 깊이 되새겼고, 생을 마감하며 다 이루신 구원 사역의 완성을 위해 전도자로서 사명을 다잡았습니다. 모든 죄의 값을 다 청산하시며 내가 다 이루었다 하신 주님의 말씀은 그 어떤 것으로도 갚을 수 없는 은혜입니다. 고난주간 특별새벽 기도회는 그 사랑을 다시 한번 일깨운 시간이었습니다. FCB 뉴스 심지입니다.
오산리 최자실 기념금식기도원은 13일 벚꽃과 함께하는 힐송 콘서트를 가졌습니다. 차승우 리포터가 취재했습니다.
따사로운 햇살에 꽃망울을 활짝 터뜨린 벚꽃이 오산리 최자실 기념금식기도원을 온통 하얗게 물들였습니다. 콘서트가 시작되며 오산리 기도원 원장 권경한 목사는 참석자들을 환영하며 진정한 행복은 예수 그리스도 안에 있다고 강조했습니다.
여러분들에게 선물하고파서 이번 벚꽃 힐링 축제를 처음으로 시작을 하게 되었습니다.
박윤신 아나운서의 사회로 진행된 콘서트는 캐리그마 찬양팀의 워십과 찬양, 국제 콩쿠르 수상자들의 연주, CCM 듀오 사랑 이야기가 아름다운 찬양을 선사했습니다. 인근 주민들과 성도 외에도 인근 부대 군종과 군인 100여 명이 콘서트에 참석해 함께 하나님을 찬양했습니다.
오늘 많은 성도들에게 그리고 장병들에게 기쁜 시간, 축복의 시간, 그리고 하나님을 영화롭게 할 수 있는 은혜로운 시간 되기를 확신합니다.
또 한국 성시어 환경 운동 본부와 굿피플 남성교회도 이날 행사를 도왔습니다. 성시어 운동 본부는 꽃이 2000포를 전했고, 굿피플은 위기 가정 및 희귀 질환 아동 돕기 캠페인을 전개했습니다.
기도를 통해서 믿음과 꿈과 소망을 갖게 되기를 주님의 이름으로 축원합니다.
기도원에서 울려 퍼진 벚꽃 축제와 함께한 힐링 콘서트의 찬양이 오산리 기도원에서 북한까지 전파되기를 소망합니다. FGTV 뉴스 차승우입니다.
순복음 강국교회는 17일 조용기 목사를 설교자로 독립 9주년 기념 축복 대성회를 가졌습니다. 보도에 이서정 리포터입니다.
순복음 강북교회의 축복성회는 예배가 시작되기 훨씬 전부터 교회에 나온 성도들로 대성전과 부속성전 모두 큰 성황을 이뤘습니다.
순복음 강북교회
이날 성회에서 조용기 목사는 4차원의 영성을 제목으로 하나님의 말씀을 선포했습니다.
여러분, 꿈이 있고 믿음이 있으면 창조적인 선언을 해야 합니다. 그럴 때 기적이 나타나는 것입니다.
말씀으로 큰 은혜를 받은 성도들은 하나님이 주신 꿈과 믿음, 입술의 고백을 다짐했고, 강북교회의 부흥주역으로 풍성한 복음 개수를 맺는 성도들이 될 것을 결단했습니다. FGTV 뉴스 이소정입니다.
이번 주 기획 뉴스에서는 지난 10일 새롭게 시작된 OTT 방송 서비스에 대해 취재했습니다.
할렐루야! 여도수목교회에서는 한국교회 최초로 여도수목교회 전용 인터넷 TV 방송인 IT 서비스를 개시하게 되었습니다. 이제 인터넷이 가능한 곳이면 세계 어디서든지 이 OTT 서비스를 이용하여 여도 수목의 예배 신앙을 TV를 통해 실시간으로 시청할 수 있습니다. 주일 예배, 수예배, 새벽 기도 및 영상 구역 공과 등 성도님들의 신앙생활에 도움이 될 다양한 콘텐츠도 구성하였으며 집에서도 OTT 셋업박스를 연결한 TV 화면으로 24시간 부활절의 예배를 시청할 수 있습니다. 이번에 개시되는 OTT 서비스는 세계 복음화의 성장 동력으로 성도님들의 신앙 고취와 견고한 신앙생활을 도모하는 복음의 통로가 될 것을 확신합니다. 할렐루야.
우리 교회는 4월 10일부터 교회 방송 OTT 서비스를 시작했습니다. 한국교회에서는 최초입니다. 쉽게 생각하면 인터넷망을 통한 교회 방송 서비스로 이해할 수 있습니다. 교회 홈페이지도 인터넷망을 사용하고 있으니 그럼 홈페이지와 스마트폰에서 볼 수 있는 교회 방송과는 무엇이 다를까 궁금하시죠? 홈페이지와 모바일에서 만날 수 있는 교회 방송이라면 VOD와 생방송 위주의 프로그램들인데요. 두 가지 모두 작은 화면에 최적화되어 있습니다. 이에 반해 OTT 서비스는 24시간 편성을 통해 우리 교회 예배와 뉴스, 영상 구역 예배, 스크린 등이 HD급 고화질로 하루 종일 방송되고 있습니다. 무엇보다 컴퓨터를 활용하여 실시간 영상을 보거나 지난 동영상을 검색하는 불편함이 없이 텔레비전을 켜는 순간 바로 실시간 방송 시청과 다양한 컨텐츠들을 마주할 수 있어 누구나 쉽게 접근할 수 있습니다. 시청을 위해서는 전용 셋업박스를 설치하면 되는데요. 제1교육관 1층에 있는 교회 서점에서 쉽게 구입할 수 있고 셋업박스 구입 이후 추가 비용이 들지 않는 것도 OTT 방송 서비스의 장점입니다. 설치 방법과 사용법은 여의도 순복음교회 앱과 홈페이지에 동영상으로 자세히 나와 있습니다.
여러분 안녕하세요. 자, 지금부터 저와 함께 OTT 설치 그리고 시청하는 방법에 대해 알아보도록 하겠습니다.
새로운 방송 환경에 발맞춰 시작된 여의도 순복음교회 OTT 방송 서비스가 선교사역의 새로운 지평을 여는 발판이 되길 기대해봅니다. FGTV 뉴스 성지연입니다.
한 주간 우리 교회 단신입니다. 교회 성장 연구소 법인 이사회가 16일 있었습니다. 이날 이사회에선 성장을 넘어 성숙함을 향해 나아가는 한국 교회가 되도록 일조한다는 교회 성장 연구소의 사명과 첫 마음을 재점검했습니다. 이영훈 목사는 14일 바른미래당 이현주 의원과 만나 환담했습니다. 주영기 목사는 16일 스리랑카 하나님의 성회 제이콥 샤스 총회장 일행과 만나 환담하고 격려했습니다. 주영기 목사는 긍정의 생각과 언어를 당부했고 일행의 사명 감당을 위해 간절히 기도했습니다. 이영훈 목사는 19일 이혜교 집사 가정을 신방했습니다. 과거 지역장으로도 섬겼던 이 집사는 현재 시력을 상실해 어렵게 생활하고 있습니다. 혼자서는 생활할 수 없는 상황이라 지역 식구들의 도움이 큰 힘이 된다고 합니다. 이날 이영호 목사는 부활하신 주님은 죄와 사망의 권세를 깨뜨리셨다며 예수님 안에서 절망을 헤쳐가자고 격려하고 권면했습니다. 순복음 세계 선교회 이사장 이영호 목사는 17일 김정중 선교사를 필리핀 민다나오로 파송하고 순전한 선교 사역을 당부했습니다. 예배 후 이영호 목사는 성전 비서실에서 교역자 순환 보직에 따른 임명장 수여를 받고 사명에 최선을 다해 줄 것을 당부했습니다. 우리 교회는 19일 금요 성령 대망의 시간에 예수 그리스도의 다시 사심을 기념하는 부활절 칸타타를 가졌습니다. 칸타타에는 주일 3부 예배를 섬기는 예루살렘 찬양대가 나서 오 크신 사랑 등을 연주했습니다. 예배는 8천만 민족 복음화를 위한 회개대성회로 진행돼 함덕기 목사가 회개의 열매를 제목으로 설교하고 민족 복음화를 위해 간절히 기도했습니다. 장애인의 날 및 장애인 대교구 31주년 기념 예배가 13일 이장균 목사를 설교자로 있었습니다. 이 목사는 주 안에 서 있는 믿음의 사람은 연약해 보이나 강한 사람이라며 성전을 넘어 부석 성전과 복도까지 성도들로 큰 성황을 이루며 장애인 대교구의 하나됨을 보여줬습니다. 우리 교회 중추기관인 안수집사회의 창립 41주년 기념예배가 14일 이장규 목사를 설교자로 있었습니다. 이 목사는 우리가 성심으로 믿음의 씨앗을 심으면 하나님은 놀라운 복을 허락해 주신다며 이를 통해 착한 일을 넘치게 하는 안수집사회가 되자고 축복했습니다. 설교 후에는 안수집사회 발전에 기여한 회원들에게 김병현 회장이 표창장을 주고 격려했습니다. 4월 장로 기도회가 19일 중앙성결교회 한기채 목사를 설교자로 있었습니다. 이날 한 목사는 삶의 현장에서 말씀의 실천은 중요하다며 하나님의 말씀을 인용하여 가르치는 것이 아니라 말씀을 잘 적용해 실천하는 것이 영적 지도자의 삶이라고 전했습니다. 설교 참석자들은 나라와 민족, 교회를 위해 또 저출산 문제 해결과 청년 실업난이 해소될 수 있도록 간절히 기도했습니다. 기독교 대한 하나님의 성회 전국 장로연합회는 14일 제35회기 제1차 임역원 회의를 가졌습니다. 회장 임창빈 장로의 주제로 시작된 고난토의에서는 제주 안귀남 장로의 임원 선임권이 상정돼 결의됐고 기타 안건으로 상정된 기하성 서대문 측과의 통합건은 통합추진위원회를 구성해 논의를 이어가기로 했습니다. 제27회 파더스림이 13일 5주간의 모든 과정을 끝내고 마무리됐습니다. 파더스림의 마지막 날 모임에는 아버지를 응원하는 가족들이 초대됐고 주님 제가 아버지입니다를 고백하는 참가자들의 고백은 모두의 가슴을 뭉클하게 만들며 큰 감동을 선사했습니다. 참가자들은 5주 동안 자녀 안아주기와 아내에게 편지 쓰기 등 과제를 수행하며 삶을 돌아봤고 아버지와 남편, 아들로서 각자의 정체성을 회복하는 시간을 가졌습니다. 관악구교구 기도처 이전미 봉헌 예배가 18일 있었습니다. 구교구 성도들의 오랜 기도와 헌신으로 아름답게 봉헌한 새 기도처에서 이철웅 목사는 이 귀한 성전 가운데 하나님이 주시는 희망과 영광이 가득하고 기도응답과 문제 해결의 장이 되도록 하자고 설교했습니다. 한국 성시와 환경운동본부 4월 부흥 집회가 14일 있었습니다. 집회를 통해 참석자들은 영적 재충전을 새롭게 했고 우리 사회의 심각한 사회 문제인 저출산 문제의 극복을 위해 한 목소리로 기도했습니다. 또 성시와 운동본부가 추구하는 건강한 가정, 깨끗한 도시를 만드는 데 더욱 헌신할 것을 다짐했습니다. 순복음의료센터는 14일 충남 보령시 천북면 장은리에 소재한 장은교회에서 사랑의 의료봉사를 가졌습니다. 마을회관에 임시진료소를 꾸린 순복음의료센터는 치과와 가정의학과, 안과, 내과, 한방, 약국 등 진료를 통해 100여 명 주민들의 아픈 몸을 살폈고 임용봉사를 통해 주민들의 머리도 예쁘게 손질해드렸습니다. 한 주간 기도원 소식입니다. 16일에는 관악대교구에서, 18일에는 양천대교구에서, 19일에는 서대문대교구에서 각각 성령대망회를 가졌습니다. 이번 주 기도원에서는 부활절 심령 부흥 대성회가 진행됩니다. 지금까지 FGTV 뉴스였습니다. 시청해주신 여러분 고맙습니다.
목사님과 다니자 목사님의 사역과 건강을 위해 평양 조용기 심장 전문병원 공사가 조속히 재개되기 위해 성령 충만과 성도 여러분들의 기도 제목들이 응답되기 위해 우리 다 같이 주여 삼창하고 기도하겠습니다. 주여, 주여, 주여.
되신 하나님이 우리와 함께 하십니다. 그 영광의 주님을 찬양할 때 주의 은혜가 우리 안에 풍성히 나타날 줄 믿습니다. 우리가 마음을 다하여서 살아계신 그 하나님을 찬양드리겠습니다. 주님을 기다립니다. 기도의
invite you to prepare your hearts by taking a few minutes to pray now. Recite the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Universal Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Seated, please turn in your hymn book to page 432. Be not dismayed, whate'er betide. God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide. God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Through every day or all the way, he will take care of you. God will take care of you. Through days of toil, when heart doth fail, God will take care of you. When dangers, fears your path assail, God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Through every day, or all the way, he will take care of you. God will take care of you. All you may need, he will provide. Take care of you. Trust him and you will be satisfied. God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Through every day or all the way, he will take care of you. God will take care of you. No matter what may be the test, his breast. God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Through every day or all the way, he will take care of you. God will take care of you. Amen. You're such a good God, Father. Father, thank you. You've been helping us until now. You're the God of Ebenezer. Lord, thank you. God, thank you for guiding us and preparing for our future. We bring you glory, praise, and honor. This is such a great day and blessed day. We are here in this holy sanctuary, and with all our hearts and all our minds, we are praising you, asking for your blessings and grace, and we are so grateful for this opportunity. Lord, meet us. And we are here because we believe that you exist and you reward all those who seek you. Well, answer our prayers and respond to us when we cry out to you. Lord God, we have been trying to live up to your will, but many times we failed, many times we followed our own ways, but we are now relying on the power of the cross of Jesus Christ. Cleanse us as we listen to your voice this morning. May we be transformed, may we be empowered, so that we can be mightily used by you. You are such a good Father. We have 50,000 churches and 100,000 pastors, and we have sent out so many missionaries throughout the world. Lord, have mercy on this country and guide us as a country in every aspect to our society, like military, like education, Help us and help us prosper. Help us create many jobs for our younger generations and even for our elderly. Give us many middle class companies and help us get rid of disparity amongst ourselves. You gave us our senior pastor and senior pastor emeritus. Give them the abundant anointing of the Holy Spirit. Fill them with your power. Fill them with spiritual power so that they can soar like mighty eagles. Even today, as he preaches your word, let those words be your message of a miracle, message of grace. And as we respond to those messages with amen, may we experience your miracles. We pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We welcome all of our foreign guests to Yeouido Full Gospel Church. This is Han Kyung, bringing your simultaneous interpretation of this service so you may be able to join us in worship. The scripture reading today is found in 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7. Let's read it together. But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the things man looks at. Man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart." Amen. You may now take off your headphones and enjoy listening to the choir music.
Thank you.
let's greet our neighbors, saying, "Today is a great day. Jesus of love is with us here and now. Something good is going to happen to you in Jesus." Something really good will really happen to you in Jesus Christ throughout our lives. As we live, the greatest blessing is that we believe in Jesus. And then, second of all, the blessing of reading the Bible and living by the grace of the Bible. And thirdly, the grace of the Holy Spirit given to us through the Word of God. So, the most urgent question is that how much do we love our Lord? If we love the Lord, the next question is, do I always dwell in the Word of God, meditating on the Word of God? And do I always have this desire for worship service? And as we listen to the sermons, as we praise the Lord, am I being touched in my heart by the grace of the Lord? They are the questions we have to ask. If we lose our faith, we lose everything. We always have to be thrilled and pleased, and by the grace of the Lord, we have to shed tears in thanksgiving. That should be the grace you have to have. I bless you in the name of the Lord. God uses people as they obey the Word of God. Although we may have flaws, we may have mistakes, but in our hearts, if we have this pure heart for the Lord and love for the Lord, God will use us. When God elected Saul, he saw humility in Saul, but he became proud, failing to obey the Word of God completely. That was how he was rejected by God. And God always does his works through obedient people. So first of all, he moved his anointing from Saul to David. That's today's topic. Chapter 15, verse 30. Now Samuel was in the process of splitting up with Saul. Verse 30, chapter 15, verse 30. Saul replied, "I have sinned, but please honor me before the elders of my people and before Israel. Come back with me so that I may worship the Lord your God." Now Saul realized that he made a mistake. So he said to Samuel, I made a mistake. It was wrong. But I urge you, I'm asking you, I'm begging you, like in front of Israelites, elders and leaders, please raise me up in front of the people, commend me before the people, and allow me to worship the Lord in front of my people. That was what Saul asked of Samuel. Now we see the problems with Saul. It was not the right request. He should have said, "Samuel, I committed sin to God. Please pray for me to God so that he can forgive my sins." That should have been the request from Saul. But he said, in reality, "Raise me up in front of my people." So then let me go worship the Lord. So he had this wrong order of things. And it may apply to all of us. When we face difficulties and problems, when we are in despair, when we make mistakes, when we are hurt, when we are are destroyed within ourselves. What do we do? We have to restore our relationship with God first. But we, many times we are worried about if the people would frown upon us, if we are criticized by the people, so we go to other people and ask for forgiveness of the people so that they can be tolerant toward us. Then we come to God. If that's our order, it is totally upside down. We have to seek first His kingdom and His righteousness. Whatever problems, whatever mistakes we may have made, we have to kneel before the Lord first and ask for His forgiveness. In my relationship with you, this is my problem. Have mercy on me. Correct me. This should be our priority. But consider Saul. It was his second priority. He first wanted to be raised up before his people, and he intended to go to God, worship him later. Samuel reluctantly agreed with Saul in verse 31. So Samuel went back with Saul, and Saul worshiped the Lord. Now Samuel accompanied Saul, but the political goal was evident. Saul wanted Samuel to be with him for political purposes, and he did not correct himself. When God told them to destroy King Agag and his belongings, but Saul failed to follow that order. Now his judgment is in verse 32. Then Samuel said, "Bring me Agag, king of the Amalekites." Agag came to him confidently, thinking, "Surely the bitterness of death is past." But Samuel said, "As your sword has made the women childless, so will your mother be childless among women." And Saul put Agag to death before the Lord at Gilgal. So Agag was sent for by Samuel, and he said to himself, "I'm safe now." So he was pleased to come to Samuel, that's what the Bible says. But at that time, Samuel was very clear that Agag was under God's judgment. So Agag was put to death by Samuel. God's judgment toward our sin is very, very strict. We may be forgiven by the Lord, but our sins will be judged, will be punished. So we should come to the Lord and repent of our sins immediately. Repentance means we turn our ways. It's not about just to have compunction, having compunction. If you only feel bad about what you did and repeat that, that's not repentance, that's just compunction. Like if you have a habit of gambling, repentance for you is to cut off that bad habit. It's not about asking for His forgiveness and repeating your sin. So after this, Saul and Samuel part ways. Now verse 34 and 35. Then Samuel left for Ramah, but Saul went up to his home in Gibeah of Saul. Until the day Samuel died, he did not go to see Saul again, though Samuel mourned for him, and the Lord was grieved that he had made Saul king over Israel. So Samuel never delivered God's message to Saul, because Saul was rejected by God since that day. So he never passed God's message to Saul. So that was complete separation. But in his heart, Samuel had this sadness towards Saul because he was the first king he anointed. So with this bitter heart, he cried out to the Lord, God, what about giving him another opportunity? So he cried and prayed, but God never changed his mind. So Saul was on the downhill. God's judgment was strict. If you have a position, if you have a office within the church, and if you keep going against God's will, then God will give you an opportunity. He will chastise you. He will chastise you to correct you. But if you keep going against God's will, if you keep disobeying his word, he may reject you. And never, we cannot afford to have that. We should remain alert. Cry out to the Lord for repentance, lifting up his name in our hearts, in our life. When you pray, you see yourself, you examine yourself, and you come to the Lord and please him. If you don't pray, you don't see yourself, fail to examine yourself, and you will be proud, filled up with human desires and greed, and you will get hurt, and you will hurt others, then that's how you lose the basic Christian life. So remain alert, remain awake. Now from chapter 16, Samuel is preparing another king. Verse 1, the Lord said to Samuel, how long will you mourn for Saul, since I have rejected him as king over Israel? Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I'm sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem. I have chosen one of his sons to be king. So Samuel spent a while mourning for Saul, but it was time for him to move on, and God ordered him to go to Bethlehem, to the house of Jesse, and anoint one of his sons. So get prepared and go to Bethlehem. Upon hearing this, Samuel thought, there's a king right now on his throne. He may be foolish, selfish, and proud. But Samuel said, how can I go? Saul will hear about it and kill me. The Lord said, take a heifer with you and say, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. So God said, go and say, I've come to sacrifice to the Lord. Don't tell them about this command I have given you. So the sacrificing to the Lord is normal job of a priest. So in verse 3, invite Jesse to sacrifice and I will show you what to do. You are to anoint for me the one I indicate. Now in the house of Jesse, now I'm going to sacrifice to the Lord here. Bring all your sons and I will anoint one of them to be king. That's God's plan. So in today's word, it means I will come to your house and bring all the sons of yours there, and I will lay hand on one of your sons who was elected by God. So in Bethlehem, at that time, the in the whole Israel, Samuel was the most respected spiritual leader in Israel, so everybody was kind of fearful. Verse 4, Samuel did what the Lord said when he arrived at Bethlehem. The elders of the town trembled when they met him. They asked, "Do you come in peace?" Now, the leaders in Bethlehem, because Samuel, they knew Samuel had a troubled relationship with Saul, so they were wondering why Samuel came to their town. Why did you come? For peace, for good events, or for judgment? And Samuel said, replied, "Yes, in peace. I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Consecrate yourselves and come to the sacrifice with me." Then he consecrated Jesse and his sons and invited them to the sacrifice. So Samuel came for peace. So let's make sacrifice to the Lord. Bring your sons. That's what Samuel said. So in Bethlehem, in that town, there was a sacrifice with Samuel. And in that process, he was about to anoint God's elected person. As you know well, Bethlehem was the town the Messiah would be born in the future, and David spiritually is the ancestor of the Messiah. Now, third point is the anointing of David. I'm sorry. Now, verse 6, when they arrived, Samuel saw Eliab and felt, "Surely the Lord's anointed stands here before the Lord." Now, in the sacrifice, when Samuel saw him, he was handsome, and Eliab, the first son of Jesse, he was very good in his appearance, so Samuel thought himself, this is the one. He was about to anoint Eliab. He must have been a good-looking guy. Now, verse 7, but the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the things man looks at. Man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. Do not elect him, out of his appearance." Doesn't make any sense. Even if he's like a handsome actor, I don't look at the appearance. I look at the heart. When we look at the appearance of others, sometimes we make a quick judgment, but we don't read the hearts of the people by looking at their appearances. So many times we face difficulties and problems because we are confused about others. Faces, they sometimes reflect the personality of others. In our church, one of the retired elders, he was vice president, CEO of Korean Air, and he said to me, "Pastor Lee, I interviewed 50,000 stewardesses. So when I see people in the face, I have this feeling that he will be like such and such. He will be picky. She will be mild. He may have temper." So there's this feeling. According to Dr. Hwang Soo-kwan, believing in Jesus and being baptized with the Holy Spirit, our appearance, our faces will be transformed. Like, it is true, we can read people through faces, but even if our faces look like angel, as far as we have devil's heart in our hearts, we are like devils. When considered deceivers, they look trustworthy, but in their hearts, they are deceivers. I mean, in the old days, some people, there was an inventor who invented a small bottle that has a functional refrigerator. So he gathered much fund from the investors, but he took the money and he went away. I mean, it was true that his invention was true. I mean, it was instant. I mean, it was an instant refrigerator bottle, but the problem was the bottle. It was more than $10 for a bottle, so it was not economic. But he gathered all the fund and he fled, basically. I mean, it was a true invention, but it was not economic. So instead of making it cheaper, then people brought fund to him. I mean, there was another case. I mean, there are so many cases. I mean, people try to get funds from others for a con job. I mean, some people said there's a treasure ship sunk in the ocean, but they were all lies, deception. So we have to ask for discernment. We have to ask for discernment. Lord, give us discernment. Now verse 8 through 10. Then Jesse called Abinadab and had him pass in front of Samuel, but Samuel said, "The Lord has not chosen this one either." Jesse then had Shammah pass by, but Samuel said, "Nor has the Lord chosen this one." Jesse had seven of his sons pass before Samuel, but Samuel said to him, "The Lord has not chosen these." So there were seven sons, and all of them pass in front of Samuel. They all look good, but God said, "No, not this one. No, no, no." So there was no more son for Jesse. So Samuel asked him, verse 11. So he asked Jesse, "Are they all the sons you have?" "There's still the youngest," Jesse answered, "but he is tending the sheep." Samuel said, "Send for him. We will not sit down until he arrives." "Do you have another son?" "Yes, I have the youngest one. He's still young, and he is," I mean, in Jesse's heart, David didn't compare with his brothers. So he was not worthy of this anointing, so he did not put him in. But God liked David. In verse 12, so he sent and had him brought in. He was ruddy with a fine appearance and handsome features. Then the Lord said, "Rise and anoint him. He is the one." Now, this is the one. Look, verse 13. So Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord came upon David in power. Samuel then went to Ramah. This is the one. As he anointed David, the Holy Spirit came upon David. In the Old Testament times, there were three offices with the anointment: king, prophets, and priests. These three offices required anointing. So meaning they were anointed they were Messiah. And that's Hebrew, and in Greek it is Christ. So Messiah, the anointed one, Christ, they are all the same expressions. Now, spiritually speaking, filled up with the Holy Spirit, being filled up with the Holy Spirit. So we are chosen by the Lord and we are anointed by the Holy Spirit. You may be the same Christian, but without the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you are weak. You will make a lot of mistakes. Why? Because you lack the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I mean, from time to time, we have to be baptized. We have to be anointed with the Holy Spirit. That's how we remain filled up with the Holy Spirit. Without the anointing of the Holy Spirit, for not even a moment, we cannot have a victorious life. So our prayer should be, Lord, fill us up with the Holy Spirit. Anoint us with the Holy Spirit. Anointing of the Holy Spirit. Let us be filled up with your Spirit and with your power so that we can be the witnesses of the gospel, bringing glory to you. We should have this burning desire for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. We need it. In this end time, being filled up with the Holy Spirit, we have to be prepared as a mighty warrior for the Lord. Otherwise, we will be attacked by the devil and we will fail. But with the anointing of the Holy Spirit, with the fullness of the Holy Spirit, we will be like Jesus in our inner heart and we will do what Jesus did in our life. So a victorious Christian life, the key to it is the fullness of the Holy Spirit alone. The fullness of the Holy Spirit is our only way. After accepting Jesus Christ, we have to remain filled up with the Holy Spirit every day, every month, every moment. Be blessed with the fullness of the Holy Spirit. When you're really filled up with the Holy Spirit, you will reflect Jesus in your heart, I mean, your life. You will be as meek as Jesus, as humble as Jesus. Pastor Michael O, he, at the age of 41, that was the youngest one who became the CEO of Lausanne Movement. He's a Korean-American. All the pastors of mega churches in Korea, they are all involved in Lausanne Movement. And he became the CEO of Lausanne Movement. And every pastors of mega churches, they were surprised because the CEO of Lausanne Movement, he represent the evangelical wing of world Christianity. And some people frowned upon his youth. I mean, he's so young. How come he can lead this great organization, this great work? I mean, there were so many people worried and they were gossiped about him. And he knelt down before the Lord and he confessed, I cannot do this, Lord. And he wrote a book titled, I'm Nothing. And he gave me a copy, and I was greatly moved by his confession. He said, I am nothing. I'm just a sinner saved by his grace. I'm a shy, inconfident, and very introvert person, and I happen to be on this great stage. I'm a weak vessel, but I was called to serve the mighty God. I'm just a little missionary, but I'm serving a great God, end of quote. Hallelujah. This is how a person of the Holy Spirit works. I am a little person, but my God is great. My God is almighty. My God is the God of power. And he goes ahead of me, and I am nothing, and I can do this. He visits Korea once or twice a year. He always calls me
and he wants to meet me for like five minutes, and I always meet him whenever he comes to Korea, and whenever I talk to him, I got encouraged and I got inspired. He is a shy and he is an introvert person, but God is using him. Why? Because of the anointing of the Holy Spirit on him. Brothers and sisters, God, as we in front of him, before him, God does not look at our ability, capability. God looks at our heart. If our number one priority is our love for him, God looks at that heart. You cannot replace this with anything. I put my life on the line to love and please you. That's our confession. There's a good singer, and he was invited to a stage. The guarantee was 100,000 Korean won. I mean 100,000 US dollar. But the invitation came from the Unification Church, the Moonies. Many people may go, but a person of faith will never go. Why? Because of love of God. We have many good musicians, and they will not go to different places. Why? Because we don't sell our Christian faith. We don't compromise it. Throughout your lives, have this burning love for the Lord, rely on him, and dedicate yourself to the Lord. Then you will receive wonderful heavenly blessings. When God opens the door of heaven, no one can shut it down, and the blessings will be poured out upon your life, and you will be blessings. Love him, please him, and be anointed with the Holy Spirit. Remain filled up with the Holy Spirit, then you will receive wonderful blessings. You will be blessings. This is the kind of blessing you will have. I bless you in the name of the Lord. Let us pray. Father God, you're full of love, grace, and mercy. All of us, may we be filled up with the Holy Spirit. May we be blessing. May we please you. May we bring honor and glory to you throughout our lives. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Please continue to keep your head bowed a little while longer. What is your life? It's like morning mist that's going to disappear soon. The greatest blessing you can have in this passing life is for you to accept Jesus as Savior and Lord. If you are a newcomer here, if you went astray in the Word, but if you want to turn to God, if you are not reassured of your salvation, if you want to dedicate your life to God, stand up wherever you are and follow after me as I pray the sinner's prayer in Korea, in Japan, in the United States, in wherever you may are, you may be right now. Stand up with your faith. Your confession of faith will give you salvation. Father God, I'm a sinner. I didn't know where I came from. I didn't know why I lived. I didn't know where I was going. I went astray in the world. But now I believe that Jesus died for me on the cross. Now I believe that Jesus was resurrected for me. Now I accept Jesus as Savior and Lord. Now I became a child of God. From now on, I will live with you forever. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Welcome in the name of the Lord. Now, our prayer request is for the fullness and anointing of the Holy Spirit throughout our lives. We want to be used by God like David was. Lord, may we have a blessed life. May we have the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Do not lose the anointing. Do not lose the anointing. When your heart is barren, when your heart is dry, you are dying spiritually. Do not die spiritually. Let us be revived. Let us rise. Let us pray for the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Let us cry out, Lord, three times and pray in unison. Lord, Lord, Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Thank you.
God will take care of you through every day or all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care of you. Put your hand on the body part you need healing. Put your hand on your hearts. Father God, you're full of love, grace, and mercy. Heal us. Heal our wounds. We have this trouble in our hearts. Heal us. Lord, we have this trouble with our family. Heal our family. In Jesus' name, be healed of all the scars. Be healed. Severe headache, insomnia, depression, neurosis, mental diseases, go away. Alzheimer's, go away. Pain in the neck and shoulders, go. Diseases in the vertebra, go away. Heart diseases and stomach diseases, go away. Hypertension and diabetes, go away. Cancers and tumors, go. Skin diseases and rare diseases, go away in the name of Jesus. Your children, be blessed. Your prayer request be answered. You are blessed. You are blessed with your workplace and business. Everything you ask for, it will be given to you. Thank you for your miracles. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God will take care of you through every day, over all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care of you. There's a person suffering from mental disease. Keep praying. Be filled with the Holy Spirit and you will be free of mental disease. Depression, insomnia, mental disease, and Alzheimer's, go with the fullness of the Holy Spirit. You will be healed. God healed someone with pain in the neck and shoulder and thyroid. And God healed someone with difficulty in urinating and in bowel movement. God healed someone with arthritis and hypertension. Brothers and sisters, when you pray, the Holy Spirit will strengthen you. Severe headache was healed, and God gave that heart peace. When you ask for something in prayer, believe that it is given to you. All of you, be filled up with the Holy Spirit to have a victorious Christian life. Let's say to each other, let us be filled up with the Holy Spirit. With joy and thanksgiving, let's give our gift of gratitude. Hallelujah. Loving Father, thank you. Under the title of David's anointing, you gave us your message, and thank you for that. Your love and your word, we are grateful for that. You allowed us to abide within your word, just like you gave us the message. Lord, thank you for this time of determination. We want to give our gift of gratitude because we are so thankful. Holy Spirit, guide our heart as we give. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
2019년 서울
Please be advised that on Sunday, English interpretation is provided for the following worship services, 7 a.m., 9 a.m., 11 a.m., and 1 p.m. On Wednesday, English interpretation is provided for our service at 10:30 a.m. On Friday, English interpretation is provided for our all-night prayer meeting from 9:30 until 11 p.m. Thank you. 나 파스터 영훈 리 will give out appreciation plaque. Pastor 박덕수, as he retires from Yeouido Full Gospel Church, Pastor 영훈 리 is giving him the appreciation plaque. Now, Pastor Cho Jung-kwon. Now, Pastor Lee Do-pyo. Pastor Lee Young-ui. Pastor Yoon Byung-ok. They have serve the body of Christ for all their life, and I give thanks to them, and I believe that God will guide their future. Now, as we approach the month of May, the month of the family, especially in our church, we will take good care of our elderly and our orphans, and that should be our campaign for the next month. All those who live alone, who have disability or any difficulty in commuting to church, our districts, our parishes will visit them, and I asked our pastors that that to make sure that you don't prepare anything, you don't serve anything. When our pastors visit your houses, only serve water. That should be it. So it applies to me. But one time, an elderly lady offered me sweet potato, so I ate it. But otherwise, our pastors will bring presents to you and will not take anything but water, a cup of water. So all those who have illness, who are alone, who are orphans, we will spend the next month visiting them, encouraging them. So you cell leaders, please consult your parish pastors to find them and to arrange meetings for them. When I visit them, I'm so grateful that our parishes, they are extending their helping hands to our neighbors, to our members who are particularly struggling financially in many other ways. Last month, I visited one of our members who are blinded, and I found that the cell members have been helping her so much. So we will continue to do that. I mean, I am healthy, so when you're healthy, you're not gonna you're going to have to wait, but for the next month, we will visit our weak members. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for your grace. We have brought this gift for your glory. manifest your glory through this gift and bless all those who gave you so that they can spend their lives serving you and sharing your gospel. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Now may the infinite grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the everlasting love of God, and the indwelling fellowship, guidance, and fullness of the Holy Spirit be with you and all of your family members abundantly. Amen. As your interpreter, it has been a pleasure to help you at this Wednesday morning Bible study. May God be with you and bless you until we meet again. Thank you.